So, hi everyone. So my topic is it's a paper presentation on simplifying the deployments, enterprise deployments, what customers have, right? Be it any kind of software environment using the artificial intelligence. So I'll quickly run through what I'll be introducing the things, how it is. And then I will say, without artificial intelligence, what are the current challenges what enterprises are facing doing with their deployments? And what are different typical scenarios, be it like cloud or on-premise or hybrid solutions, right? Then I also have like what AI, how AI is solving the things for the deployments. And then I'll quickly conclude the things. Okay, so to introduce, so we have an AI for deployments. So be it a cloud deployment, where everything is on cloud, SaaS-based services, or anything sitting in the private cloud, or be it a deployment, where everything is within the enterprise or customer environment. So how AI is solving these things is automation, which is the very core thing of any solution, right? To get the things automatically done. Also, which also includes the RPA, Robotic Process Automation. So including this automation and robotic process automation, and with the power of the machine learning, we can achieve the AI for the deployments, enterprise deployments. So how this whole system works is, this is how the whole system works. So when we talk about the different challenges without these are distributed multi-node, multi-tenant landscape. So when a customer, for example, having a on-premise environment, so any software which goes out, it depends on many other softwares, be it from the same vendor or it from a different vendor. For example, I take an example of analytics software, which is my domain. So it has a database, it has a cloud environment. Again, the main complexity which comes is from the security point of view. Everybody is really worried about security, be it within on-premise environment or cloud, right? So everybody wants the best solution for them to achieve that. But and to authentication and other configurations, right? So all this has to be properly configured to achieve the best solution for a customer enterprise. The next is frequent updates of the software. So major challenge which what AI is trying to solve here with the deployment is frequent updates for the software. Whenever any software is updated or upgraded in the customer environment, be it on-premise or in the cloud, they need to be very sure that everything works fine before they roll out to the business users, right? So there the main challenge happens, because even the cloud softwares are like very frequently changing. Some companies are doing in a daily basis, they are upgrading their softwares. So it should not break, which also in turn helps the development organizations to do the better things with this. And also the multiple landscape. So in general, whether it's on-premise or cloud, generally have little less of this. But generally in on-premise, every software will have different landscapes, be it staging, development, test, or production. Because generally nobody touches the production by default and updated. But cloud, it happens. So everybody, whether it's development organization, whether the companies which are deploying the software, or whether it's a customer organization, they need to be very sure that after upgrade, automatic upgrade from development team organization, nothing breaks in their production environment. So these are the key major challenges what AI is trying to solve. So I'll talk about the different typical scenarios what I'll be covering here. One is the cloud scenario, where multiple tenants are involved. Like I just mentioned, be it a staging tenant or a production tenant or a testing tenant, all need to be in sync at some point of time, right? Because whatever you have built in your development environment or a test tenant has to finally roll out to the production tenant, right? So there the major challenges happen. Are you guys able to see the screen? Maybe they can switch off the lights. The next is the on-premise, where different nodes and different systems are involved, be it a database system or an analytical system or any other user storage system are involved. The next is the hybrid, which is even more complex. Complexities of on-premise are also there in that. Complexities of the cloud environments are also there, but which becomes very complex. But everything has to work fine after all the things, all the changes. So in the cloud environment, the multi-tenant architecture is what every companies are supporting with the hyperscalers in the market, right? Be it from Microsoft, Google, or any other company, right? Then we have microservices-based architecture. One service works with many other services together, right? So all these things need to work and to support multiple customers in one go, so that everybody can achieve better quality of the software. To do the extensive, intensive quality assessments and complex authentication and all, which is very much required because of the high frequency of updates. Like in cloud, like I mentioned, many companies are doing weekly, bi-weekly, or even daily, right? So everything has to be working. This is the key things in the cloud scenarios. Then so this is how a cloud environment will look like. You have one store with where all admin is taking care of things. Then you have a SAML-based authentication, which where it communicates to different identity providers where for storing of the users. And then it could have external IDP. It could be even Microsoft AD or any system. And then it could be internal IDP also. So all these things should work in a complete synchronous manner to achieve that. Again, from the on-premise point of view, multi-tier is complex architecture having client, web, and processing services. So on-premise is there from like ages, right? Even before we have come. But and the complex architectures are there. But now people are really looking for the simplicity, and now people are really looking what business user want, right? Because earlier it was, everything was handled by the IT guys. Now business user wants all the powers in their hand so that they can do everything. Need to build and utilize skills for handling deployments on-premise for different. So generally, when in any organization, there will be separate department who takes care of the security, because security is a key thing. Who takes care of authentication, who takes care of other different. So all have to build that niche skills. But now business user want that in their hands. So these are the typical on-premise solution thing. Even from a development point of view, end-to-end testing for complex landscape for every release is very much required. This is what even the development organization who are releasing these kind of softwares are looking for. So that once it goes into the production, customer should be very comfortable in moving things directly into the production, right? So this is where the key thing, once you achieve all the automation, all the RPA, everything, right, you can do all this kind of testing. So for the on-premise point of view, this is how the from very old to the till now, what we have a complex architecture looks like. You have different authentication, you have different clients, you have different web tiers from hundreds of companies, you have different processing tiers, which are talking about different solutions, you have different file storage, all these things should be in place. And above all, there is a clustering at all the levels. So if anything breaks, your whole system will break. So this is where the AI is providing the power to achieve all these complexities. Okay, so when I talk about the hybrid, right, it's a combination of everything. Your on-premise complexity, your cloud complexity, security, authentication, everything. Orchestration between your different on-premise, private cloud. People, many customers even approach for the private cloud. They want everything in their private cloud, be it a SaaS-based application, which even create more complexities there. Or a third-party public cloud. So this is how the overall complexity look like. You have a cloud environment, which is sitting in the cloud environment, be it a customer cloud or any other cloud, and this is your on-premise. So everything has to work perfect. So how AI is solving, which was the key thing in my paper also. You can find the details in that paper book. Multiple tools and automation are available for the deployment and software testing, which many companies are already using, be it the customer companies or be it a development organization. But RPA framework and RPA bots, based on AI technology, addresses all these complexities scenario using simple way of NLP, machine learning algorithms, integrating all these things together, we achieve the simple form of automated deployments. In a way, it reduces the TCO for the enterprises and also for the enterprise organization, development organizations. So this is the key thing what my paper is also talking about. And embedding, how this can be achieved? This can be achieved by embedding all these things in one single solution, be it your cloud solution or be it your on-premise solution. So this is how the AI is trying to solve this problem using different solutions. Okay, so how it works? In a simple way, it's end user inputs its request, be it using a Siri, be it a mobile app, or be it even Alexa. So for example, I give you an example of say any big organization, enterprise organization, CEO wants to check a sales report from any of the region, right, for their company. They'll simply say, talk to their Alexa or even their mobile app, which is for cloud solution. It need not bother what is the solution, what is the thing sitting here. Currently what they're doing, they have to go into the app, search for the required document, which can provide that information, go to do all the filtering and get the details out, which is even at the CEO level, right, it's too complex for them. But how this works is, they just talk, okay, give me the sales report from, say, from North America region. That's it. System will understand what document need to be triggered, what is the underlying complex environment to get that, it could be, database could be sitting in some remote area where all the information is getting fed. But from a CEO or from a business user point of view, it doesn't matter. So there is a NLP synthesizer, which is powered by ML, which we are trying to see here, which will do all these things. Convert the normal conversation into the NLP and understand it, and with power of ML, we are trying to achieve that. And how it works, it converts that all that information, what it has gathered based on the NLP input, right? It converts it into the RPA framework understandable. Then RPA framework understand what it has to do, what kind of information comes to RPA framework. Some could be pre-configured using the machine learning rules, or some could be understandable or trained by the machine learning for the RPA. Then we have a RPA framework which will be sitting there. It can be part of the enterprise software itself, where the controller will control what all things, what kind of inputs are coming to it. Generator will kind of generate the things, and then it goes to the RPA bot, which will actually communicate to the underlying complex environment, be it whatever enterprise environment I just showed, right? It will talk to all those systems, because now it has RPA bot with this overall process, it has got what it really wants, what kind of step. Okay, first do this step, then do this step. So RPA bot has got that information, and it keeps on learning, because we are training the RPA bot based on the ML, which is part of the NLP synthesizer. And then it simply sends or shares the results in form of voice as a user, based on the user input. Okay, user wants a voice output only, then it will go as a voice output. Like for example, some number. If they want a mail, user will get a mail based on what user has input at the input time. So this is how the whole of the process works, and the NLP synthesizer will take care of doing all those things. What a complex environment currently people are doing manually, or currently people has to take care. And with the power of ML, the complete system will keep on getting trained, learn, and do the things automatically going forward. So that's what I conclude. With the RPA automation and the power of ML, we can achieve the overall artificial intelligence for simplified deployments. then bots processing request and getting trained using ML. Since ML power is there, the bots which are actually processing bots will keep on storing and keep on getting trained with the ML power that what it has to do. If similar request comes, say for example somebody else requests again to the same system, get me some information from EMEA region, right? It knows what it has to do next. Only maybe the underlying query will change. That's how the bots are getting trained. Again, from the deployment point of view, it's cloud, on-premise, hybrid. What all can be achieved? Hybrid not just mean on-premise to cloud. It can also mean within cloud environment, you can touch base upon many other systems, many other solutions within cloud. And it's an overall benefit for both development organization for improving the quality, since you get everything automated done, right? So obviously, you'll have better quality improvements, which is very much required for customers to work in the productive manner, and also for the business user to get rid of the dependency on the IT guys for each and everything and get the faster results in their hands. Yeah, that's it from my side. So, and now I'm open for any questions if you guys have. No, we are using the inbuilt. We'll be using the inbuilt. That's it. No, not really within the organization. It's even for the customers. The example which I gave, it's from the customer point of view, right? Customer will maybe talk to Alexa or Siri or even mobile app for that particular solution, right? And then the overall process, the whole underlying system, landscape will take care of doing the things. Maybe some minimal configuration will be required at that point of time, which even the business user can do. And then it will be, they will get the faster results. Even this can be achieved for the call centers.
It's quite interesting to see the concepts of AI and ML come together here, please.
Sorry.
Can you see me?
Yeah.
So just wanted to know if it's possible to have a demo maybe later of the entire process workflow. Is it possible?
Not really. It's kind of under development. So
okay.
This is more of a technical type
okay.
of presentation.
Okay. All right. Sure. Yes. Yeah.
So what kind of machine learning are you using Siri or Alexa processes the voice, what kind of machine learning are you using? Classification?
Currently what we plan to use is rule-based machine learning, which is there. And also the training, it's a more of a existing algorithms, which are there already in the system.
The question is, if you just tell Siri or Alexa to invoke an action, give a command and invoke an action, and then create a script, and then pull the script, it will perform the same thing. You don't really need a machine learning there.
No, machine learning is for the training purpose of the bot. Machine learning is for the training purpose.
Okay, so you're training the bot, actually.
Yes, training the bot.
Okay.
It's mainly for that purpose. Otherwise, the RPA or even the existing NLP can do that. But the training for training purpose, machine learning is being used. Sorry, which part? Yeah. Yes. Sorry, I'm not able to hear you. No, not really.
Yeah, hi. So there was a flow that was shown there, like end user input and he providing the water to Alexa and then it gets routed to the RPA controller and all. So this is more about, say, a person provides some input and then doing the NLP synthesis and then applying like the ML algorithms or something to trigger a specific bot which has to then do some like run some further ML models for some training, or how exactly this is like a deployment AI for deployment?
See, deployment is majorly like what enterprise deployments are there, what I showed as a cloud or on-premise deployment. But this will be like part of that deployment. It could be like an admin kind of activity there, and where admin can configure all the deployments and get it done. It's not like a separate system which will do. It will be part of that same environment.
I want to understand, like, whatever the user input is there, is it just being used like a training data for some model to get trained? Or the input is there, it is used to trigger a deployment. Like, I want to deploy this.
Even you can do that. It could be anything. Like, anything can be achieved. Not just training. Training purpose is for the future use. So, for example, I have triggered one deployment using some, third-party user storage. So it could be ADFS, right? Tomorrow I want to do something with some other LDAP configuration, for example. So there, the bot will have some information, okay, I need to do this with the required system, and all those information it will try to ask the user, like, where is the system? If it doesn't have that information, and then do the same thing again.
So I can use voice commands to deploy something?
Yes, exactly.
Oh, he's out. Okay. Yes.
Hi, how does the CI/CD part come into picture for deployment?
Okay, CI/CD, like, for example, when you're doing the actual deployment for the cloud, right?
It could be on cloud or it could be
on-premise also. Right. So, CI/CD is just doing the automating the things, right? So, automation is there, but how to trigger that automation automatically is something what AI is trying to do.
Okay, that RPA part, that's where the triggering part happens?
Yes. So RPA, like, I think they removed. The system is going off. So what RPA is trying to do is, it's triggering those steps, identifying those things, and NLP synthesizer is trying to identify those steps, and then it will trigger, pass that information to RPA system, RPA framework, and there RPA framework will take care of doing this step-by-step CI/CD
An NLP synthesizer, is it a machine learning model or?
No, it's an NLP based. It's powered by machine learning, but it's a more of an NLP.
It's NLP machine learning.
Yes.
Okay.
Combination of machine.
Is it trainable?
Sorry?
Is it trainable?
Yes. That's what ML is doing.
Because in the bot part, you said that it learns continuously.
Yeah.
The same thing happens with NLP synthesizer?
Yes.
It keeps on learning.
It keeps on learning.
Is this bot supposed to be conversational? Like, let's say I have two applications and both those applications need different inputs to be provided to them.
Yeah.
So can these bots be conversational to ask the inputs on what is required?
NLP synthesizer, which is there, right? That takes care of that. If bot needs some additional information which is not really available or which is not yet trained to the bot, it will ask to the user. Okay. Say, for example, I say, I want this, I want to deploy a cloud deployment in North America. In North America, there can be multiple regions, right? Multiple data centers. So if that information is not provided, then bot may ask to the user in form of voice or in form of whatever input user is trying to give, okay, which data center you want to deploy. So that kind of things bot will ask. Okay, thank you.